HIMT, Hindustan Institute of Maritime Training.
Now, as far as bilging is concerned, how do you define bilging?
Loss of buoyancy from that compartment.
Loss of buoyancy. Or in other words, some part of your underwater volume has been replaced with seawater. What was providing buoyancy earlier, your underwater volume, which was being displaced, something is lost there, is it not? So the one way of looking at it is there is a loss in underwater volume due to the bilging. The other way to look at it is some seawater has entered. That means your ship's displacement has increased. Not really. Let's see how. But before we continue further, you need to understand that we are only going to deal with box-shaped vessels. Ship-shaped, as of now, not required for your exam purposes. But towards the end, we'll just see how to go about it, just for academic sake. Otherwise, we'll not do it for exam purposes. So we'll start with the box-shaped vessel. And even in this box-shaped vessel, we are going to look at a box-shaped barge which has a midship compartment first. What do you understand by the word midship compartment? It means the centroid of the barge as well as the compartment is same. Are you able to imagine that? Why we are talking about a midship compartment is, in case that compartment gets bilged, the ship is not going to develop any trim change or list. It is only going to suffer a bodily sinkage. Are you able to understand? That is why we are talking about a midship compartment. Are you clear what is midship compartment? It is right along the center line, equidistance on either side, and same way it is at midship, equidistance in the forward and aft part. That is a midship compartment. Now, I have put small b here, capital B here. Capital B is the barge breadth. Sometimes this compartment can extend from side to side. That means these two will be equal. But otherwise, remember, this small b represents the compartment breadth, but it is a midship compartment. Any doubt? What is a midship compartment?
Once more?
Or, if you want to understand it better, look at the top view of this barge. It's a rectangle. This is the center of the barge. If you take the compartment is located in such a way that the center of the compartment also, which is a rectangle, coincides with the ship's center.
It is considered as always center, or it can be center?
No. We are just starting off understanding concept of bridging using this midship compartment. Later we will go to compartments which are located one side, forward, aft. That's different. Now, to start with, it's a midship compartment. This is the most simplest way of understanding.
So what is the small b in the
tank?
Compartment.
If you capital B is the barge top.
So it's only for the center tank or any tank?
So we are only looking at one center tank.
Oh, okay. Only one tank.
Only one tank. Yes? Understand what is that midship compartment now? Now, this barge is now floating at a certain draft. And now let's assume that this midship compartment is bilged. What is the first and foremost thing which I would like to know at the earliest?
How much bilging is inside the midship compartment?
And end result, what is it going to do to my ship? Whether after this bilging my ship can survive it or not. That means what is going to be my final draft after bilging? That is the basic thing which I require first. And please remember, it's a midship compartment, it's going to get bilged. As the vessel gets bilged, vessel is going to sink. And then what will happen, as the vessel sinks, the water will keep coming in furthermore until there is a equilibrium. That means the water level inside and outside will be equal. Yes, otherwise this was an empty compartment. It gets bilged, water level inside and outside is going to be the same. So it's not straightforward solution how I can get the final draft. It's not like I'm going to add so much tons of water in a tank. How much will be my final draft? That's easy to get. But here, I don't know what is going to be the final level at which it is going to attain that equilibrium. Is it not? So my quantity is not known. Which is why this change of displacement method is not very friendly. Are you able to understand? How much weight is going to come, I don't know. Without that, how can I know my final displacement to calculate my final draft? So we are going to look at another way, as he said, that there is a loss of buoyancy. Prior to bilging, this was part of your underwater volume?
Yes, sir.
That is providing buoyancy, that is displacing water. But now, after bilging, is it part of your displacement? Remember, displacement means water displaced by your ship's underwater portion. Is it part of your displacement? This portion is gone. It's no more part of your vessel. Vessel displacement. But as far as the barge is concerned, I have not physically taken or added any weight. That means the barge's displacement has, the weight hasn't changed. Physically nothing is taken out or added. This is just loss of buoyancy. So, since this buoyancy is lost, the ship has to regain that buoyancy. How will it regain? Only way is by sinking. So the ship is going to sink to a new draft. It is going to sink by a margin S. I know this initial draft D. The first and foremost I am interested in calculating how much is going to be this S. Will I have sufficient freeboard after that to survive? That's what the most basic thing I need. Are you able to understand? So the buoyancy is lost, ship has sunk to regain that lost buoyancy. This is the concept which you are going to apply here. This method or this application of this concept is called constant displacement method. Meaning, my ship's weight has not changed. Lost buoyancy is regained by sinking.
Sir, initially the barge has some displacement, just take 100 tons. If that bilging has occurred, that means that center part of that compartment has immersed in the water, the bilging has occurred.
Correct.
So it will change the displacement.
Is that water free to go in and out?
Yes.
Is it part of my solid weight of the ship? If it was a tank, it had a liquid. You can say that is part of my ship's weight. But now, isn't this water which has occupied this compartment free to go out also?
It can go out.
It means it is connected to the water outside?
Water outside.
That means it is not part of my ship's displacement?
Correct. Part of
the exactly. So is this concept or thought slightly different? It takes time to accept that. But is it clear that why I am not taking this water part of my ship's weight?
Even if it is entirely immersed also, that it cannot, just for example, entirely immersed also, that it is not a part of the.
No, because it is still free, connected to the water outside. It is not exclusively weight of my ship. Is that clear? Why I cannot take this water part of my ship's weight? But if there is a tank here, it had liquid. That is part of my ship's weight. Sir, that is not connected to the water outside.
If I'm not wrong, that in the dry docking concept, you said when it touches the keel block, after that water which is there, it is affecting the displacement, no sir?
There it is intact.
Intact.
Here it is bilged. There in dry dock throughout it was intact only, no? There also it was a slightly new concept where there was an upthrust created.
Because of
that resting. So that was a change of concept which we had not applied so far. Same thing here. We are first time talking about breach of hull. Which is why that water which is inside is not part of my ship. Are you able to understand this?
Sir, if in the middle compartment, the water level will be up to the dotted line actually.
Up to the dotted line inside as well as the outside draft.
Yeah. Only that that area between the red line and the dotted line on the other compartments will be empty space.
Here it is all intact. Here it is built.
That is providing the additional buoyancy.
Exactly. Good. That comes to our next point.
Sir, we red line on the draft.
Initial draft.
Initial draft.
Initial water. Bilge aayiruchu water ulla varudhu. Adukapra on the S line on
the then sink down. This was earlier providing buoyancy to my ship. Yes. Now it is not providing buoyancy. So my ship's weight has not changed. That means I have to regain this lost buoyancy. Correct? How to regain? There has to be an increase in underwater volume to regain this lost buoyancy.
Yes.
This was originally providing buoyancy, now it is not providing buoyancy. I have to get back that. How to get back? Only way is to sink. Now by sinking, I have regained this much volume. But can I include this portion as part of my regained volume?
No.
Why?
Because that is
that is still in the bilge compartment, free to go in and out. It means that only this and this I can take it as part of my regained buoyancy. This cannot be taken as regained buoyancy.
So that is compensating for this loss.
Exactly. This loss is compensated by only this portion of regained. Are you able to understand? Whatever buoyancy is lost has been compensated only by this portion. Now let's put that in an equation form. The basic concept. Lost buoyancy is equal to regained buoyancy. Whatever I lost, that much only I need to regain. Any doubt on that?
No.
Yes? Now, lost buoyancy. Can you give it to me in a form of length, breadth, height? How much is that volume?
Initial volume, initial draft.
Length into breadth of the compartment?
Into
the initial draft. That was the lost buoyancy. How much is the regained buoyancy? I will take this whole portion
minus
subtract this, correct?
B plus S.
Minus L into minus L into B.
Plus L into B into S.
Yes.
Correct? If I take S common. Is it not? So now you see, I'm just taking it onto the other side. Now look at what data has come here, which is going to help me calculate S. L and V is the compartment dimension. D is the initial draft. Initial draft. L into B is the length and breadth of the barge. Again, this is the length and breadth of the compartment. All these are available to me initially only.
Yes, sir.
I am not worried about the final condition. Does this give me how much the ship is going to sink?
Yes, sir.
With that, can I find out D1, which is the final draft after sinking?
Yes, sir.
As long as I have sufficient freeboard to withstand that, I am happy.
Yes,
that means it gives me time to take action. This is very simple. As far as I am concerned, most basic thing, whether I can survive this damage. This is what by this. Is it not?
This is change and drop. Sinkage.
Sinkage. Due to bilging.
Constant displacement method.
This whole thing which we have come up with is called constant displacement method.
The ship's displacement is.
We will go only by constant displacement.
Only for example.
You want any other method?
No, for example.
One method is.
Sir, definition.
Definition of?
Constant displacement.
Where lost buoyancy. Is regained by sinking of the vessel.
To
pass. This pass, no?
Red to pass, kadi. Aadha
mujhe okay.
Complete.
Okay. Mail or pass to
pass. Now, we have got this mathematically. How to define this? Can I rewrite this as L into B into D? What is this?
Underwater volume of the compartment. Lost buoyancy.
Lost buoyancy. What can I say this? Total length into breadth minus compartment
length into breadth.
Look at this diagram. This is the total length into breadth. Can I call this
area.
Full
area.
Water plane area?
Full water plane area.
Minus
water plane area of the compartment.
Lost area.
Lost
area.
Why this area is lost? Because there water has gone up to there. Can I call this as part of my water plane area? So the total water plane area
will be increased.
Minus lost water plane area. We call it intact water plane area.
Lost water.
Yeah.
Tank layer is lost.
See, has this water come right up to here?
Yes.
Is it part of my water plane area?
Yes, sir.
Because this and all is
intact.
Only in the middle portion, wherever bilging has taken place, the water has come up to here. So I cannot take it as part of my water plane area. This is the lost area. This is the total area minus lost. Net result, I call it intact water plane area. So this becomes lost buoyancy by intact water plane area. Clear on this. Initially we talked about this compartment empty. Let us say there is some cargo here. Loaded maximum inside the compartment. Now bilging has happened. Will the sinkage be exactly same margin?
No.
Quite
more.
Depending on
will be more or less.
Less.
How?
Because the area
is it clear that the amount of space available for water to enter has reduced because of cargo presence?
Yes.
That means less water is going to enter. So can I say this entire volume up to here, can I call it lost buoyancy?
No.
The whole thing is not going to get flooded.
Only available
broken space is going to get filled up with water. Now, here we give a term called permeability. Permeability means space available for flooding expressed as a percentage. Space available for flooding expressed as a percentage. So permeability 20% means what? Only 20% space is available for flooding.
Of
the volume which is
compartment.
Of the compartment.
Space available for the flooding in terms of percentage.
Expressed as a percentage. Now let's see how this formula will get modified if there is carbon permeability.
Some example, 90% is filled, then bilging is occurred.
We are only worried about what is affecting up to the final D1. Mm-hmm. As long as the cargo is above that, we will take the same permeability. Whether there is space little bit here or there, how does it affect this portion?
Water volume.
It's not going to change in any way. Because water is not going to go up to there. If there was no cargo, we would have left it here.
No percentage.
Because it is percentage. So it effectively becomes, for example, in this case, only 20% of this volume is lost. Correct? Not the whole volume. Is this whole area lost? Here also cargo is there, no? In the final water line? So can we take the whole area lost? Again percentage has to come here also.
As you talk about water enters into that tank, the water is not considered as part of ship.
No.
So in this case, is the cargo considered as part of ship?
Yes, because the cargo is going to remain with the ship. The cargo is going to remain with the ship.
Means if it was in a solid type of cargo.
Yeah, I am talking about solid cargo. Permeability means in liquid cargo there is no permeability, you know.
It will replace.
Yeah.
It will replace.
It will
replace.
Ah. Depends on density. If it was liquid cargo inside.
Density
flows out.
How much?
All of you are aware that before this double hull requirement came for tankers, tankers were single hull earlier. But at the same time, for bulk cargo ships or general cargo ships, DB was compulsory. For tankers, it was not compulsory. Why?
They thought water will not increase.
Exactly.
No, the head will be. Either the tank is.
The eye will be floating and the density is less.
Because of the density.
At any point of time, when you are going to load your ship, you are going to have a certain freeboard. But definitely the cargo which you are going to load, 96-98%, whatever it is, the level is going to be much higher than that.
Yes.
Now if this compartment gets bilged, what will happen to your ship's draft?
Freeboard will increase.
Freeboard will increase, draft will reduce.
Yes, draft will reduce.
Because that, from right? Draft to that liquid will go up.
This liquid will go
out. And then the equilibrium will reach.
Exactly. So the ship is now actually in a better position, appears to be. Is it not after bilging?
Pollution is there.
Pardon?
Pollution is there.
Ah, at that time, that was not kept in mind while saying that tankers need not have DB. But even now, a tanker with DB, after bilging, it is going to increase its draft. It is more likely that it will increase because it's going to first flood the DB and then only the tank. Even if it is a side tank, it is going to fill the tank, only then there are chances of it entering the cargo tank. So here it's going to cause an increase in draft for sure.
Means at the present scenario.
No, present issue.
This is also for draft requirements. Road line consumption is enough.
Even for road line requirements.
Freeboard is less.
While freeboard is less for tankers. One aspect is this safety. The other is construction wise. Openings are much lesser.
Much lesser than the bulk area.
Bulk area, the openings are much more.
Bulk area, this is the case, like suppose it is filled with cargo and water ingress, that time you will be more worried about the stresses, no sir, than this one.
Yeah. See,
stress will be high.
Stress is something which I am going to be worried about, no doubt about that.
Because but that is that
first and foremost, I can only sit and calculate stress if my freeboard is safe enough, no? That is the immediate concern. Stress will be coming up, definitely. No doubt about that. Is this concept clear? But how to calculate this permeability? For that, this is something exclusively for exam purposes we are going to do this. What is the difference between storage factor and relative density? They are supposed to be inverse. That's how we take in all your codes, they give actually inverse values. But here from exam point of view, they give a slight difference to it. Density means it's purely of that substance. A grain of cargo. If you take how much is the actual density, like an ore or coal, if you just take one grain, that gives the density. Whereas storage factor by definition is the volume occupied by 1 ton of cargo. As far as storage factor is concerned, they include broken storage. That is space available for flooding. Whereas density means they talk only pure substance. So for calculation purposes, this is how they differentiate slightly. So storage factor includes broken storage, but relative density doesn't include that. So how to calculate this permeability? First of all, I am interested in knowing broken storage. Storage factor includes broken storage, but I told you density
doesn't
include that. So storage factor, what is the unit? Cubic meter per ton? Density or relative density is tons per cubic meter. So how can I subtract it? I have to take this inverse of it. Now what do I get? Only broken storage. Yes, this is the space available for flooding. So when I talk about permeability, broken storage by, I told you it's expressed as a percentage of space available for flooding. Percentage of space available for flooding. So out of this whole storage factor, only this broken storage is available for flooding. So if I want to now put it as a simple formula, this is how we calculate.
This is for cargo, particular cargo.
For a specific cargo.
Not for the compartment.
No, this effectively means for the compartment. Also.
Whatever cargo may be compartment.
The compartment is carrying that same cargo. Only this much is available for flooding.
So this partly for the compartment.
No. We are talking about that compartments is having cargo
above the one.
So we are not talking about partly fit, correct?
Completely fit.
It's completely filled, you can take it.
If it is a partly filled, you have to change.
You have to, yeah, you have to allow only up to that
level.
You have to
something.
Take off the lost buoyancy as space available only up to that level.
And above
beyond
the
that, full.
Yeah, full.
Full.
Okay, explain the broken storage part.
Yeah, broken stowage is the space available within the cargo.
In between the
cargo, which is there available for flooding. But how to get that? So here they make a slight variation in the definition between stowage factor, relative density. Stowage factor means volume occupied by 1 ton of cargo. That includes broken stowage. Whereas density means it's pure substance. It doesn't talk about the space around it. So how to find out broken stowage? Stowage factor minus, I cannot subtract density directly because they are inversely related. I take 1 by RT. That way what I will get? Only broken stowage. But I want permeability to be expressed as a percentage so that I can allow for the whole thing. So how to get it as a percentage? Broken stowage divided by stowage factor of this entire cargo. Okay, let's straight away do one numerical. Barge length 180, breadth 30, floating salt water at a draft of 6 meters. It has a midship compartment. Extending from 30 to side. That means compartment breadth also is 30.
Yes.
Have a cargo of permeability 30%. Calculate the final draft. This midship compartment is bilged. So generally in your exam they will mention either the compartment is extending from side to side or they will give you the breadth.
Video possible.
Okay, so solution for this. So sinkage is lost buoyancy, length into breadth into draft into permeability, correct? So So maybe 50, 30 by 100, can I just put it as 0.3?
0.3.
Capital L will be good.
0.3.
Again, permeability here also, 0.3. So final graph will be
6.3.
And as you said, if there was no cargo in this compartment, the sinkage would have been 1.2 meters. Are you clear?
No.
So presence of cargo is reducing the volume available for flooding. Let me just take off this 0.3 here and here.
1.2.
You will find answer is 1.2 meters.
7.2.
Final graph will be 7.2 meters. Right. Okay, we'll take a break. After this, we'll continue.
Rolling, sir.
Okay, I am modifying this question slightly. Compartment dimensions, everything same. The compartment had 8 flat at a height of 1.5 meters from keel. That means, can you say that it's something like a DB tank? Yes? And above that tank top is your cargo hold. So the cargo is contained only in the cargo hold, not inside the DB. Now try and calculate how much is going to be the new draft. Will it be the same? Will it be different? But here, please understand, the bilging has happened only in the cargo hold.
Only in the cargo.
Not in the DB.
How
it is possible? That is what is
damage from the side. Compartment is extending from side to side. No, so the damage was probably by a hit which happened above the watertight flat. Right? You can take it that way. Same permeability. This is intact.
Apna 6 minus 1.5.
Ah, correct. Correct. Lost points, how much will it be?
6 minus 1.5.
Only this height, no?
Yes.
Only this will be lost buoyancy?
Yes, sir.
Because this is intact. So correct? 6 minus 1.5? Or should we take the whole draft?
No.
Because I told you DB is not bilged. And again, permeability. Now tell me, should I apply permeability here? What did I say the denominator term is? Intact water plane area. Now after bilging, the draft is going to increase. Look at the water plane area. Is the cargo affecting the water plane area? Yes, that means permeability you have to apply. Clear? So you think it will be less than 0.32 or more than 0.32? Last answer you got 0.32. No?
Less than 0.32.
Give me less than 0.32. The Because from 6 this has become 4.5. How much is it?
Final answer you have to do with 4.5 only then.
Draft is 6 meters. Sinkage is 0.24. Final draft will be 6.24. But as far as last buoyancy is concerned, it is only this portion. Here on this. So I am modifying this question slightly. Apart from dimensions here, it has a watertight flap. Height of 8 meters from the keel. Now calculate the final drafts after this compartment gets bilged. No cargo, no permeability, nothing. Empty hold. Everything is open. See, it's like this. Let me draw the figure.
There will be 6 meters.
0.8.
What flat intact will be?
6 meters are there. Calculate the final drafts after this compartment gets finished.
Yes.
How much will it be?
Same as before.
6 meters.
No.
6.32 is with cargo. There is no cargo here.
7.2.
7.2.
Yes, sir.
All of you agree on this?
Yes, sir.
That means this watertight flat, does it have any bearing on this question?
No.
Why were you able to say the 7.2 immediately? Was because you already knew that my draft was 7.2 without any watertight flat.
Yes, sir.
Correct? Now, even with this watertight flat I have inserted now, you can still very well imagine that it is going to have no role to play. It's as if the compartment had no watertight flat, correct? Because you already knew that my final draft was
7.21.
Okay, now let's say I am changing this watertight flat
to 7.
See, 5 meters means nothing to worry.
7.
I will take 7, 6 minus 5.
Seven.
How much was it? 1 meter has lost buoyancy. I can calculate. Now I am going to introduce this watertight flag at a height of 6.5 meters above keel. You would understand, there is a watertight flag at a height of 6.5 meters above the keel.
Now, first 7.2 minus 6.5.
Now, this cannot be done in one step. Why?
We don't know. We don't know.
Remember, what is the denominator you got? Yes? Now, why this denominator came? Do you remember the reason? If you took as this as the original graph, we were subtracting this as part of my regain buoyancy.
Yes.
That is why this denominator has come this way. S would have come on either side. This minus small into B is coming is because I am excluding the space as part of my regain buoyancy. So if there is no watertight flag, I have to exclude this. But if the bilging was up to only this DB, will I exclude this space? There's no space to exclude. Ship is going to be built, I mean the loss buoyancy is only this portion. So I don't have to subtract this. This is all part of my regain buoyancy. But whereas in this particular sum, up to 6.5, I have to exclude this as part of regain buoyancy. Yes? No?
Yes.
Why? Because it is in the bilge compartment. But above 6.5, I don't have to exclude that compartment. So, like I explained now, I have to do it in two stages. How? Assume sinkage is 0.5 meters. It means up to the water depth. Okay? But before that, tell me how much is lost buoyancy?
L into B minus 6.
6, that's it. Up to the original graph only is lost buoyancy, you know. How much is this coming in value?
5400 cubic meters.
Assume that I am going to sink by 0.5. So regain buoyancy.
into 0.5
minus this portion. Is that part of my regain buoyancy inside that hold?
No.
How much does this come to?
2.5.
Have I regained enough? That means my final draft is going to be more than 6.5 for sure. I have already calculated up to 6.5. Can I use this figure? Can I continue from here? So volume yet to regain?
3150.
Yeah. Now this 3150 is volume yet to regain. That means the ship is going to sink above this watertight flat by margin, let's say x, and that will be equal to this volume. What I regain more? That whole volume, because now this is all part of my regain volume. Bilging is going to stop here after the water dead flat. That's all bilging. How much is x coming?
0.58.
It will sink more.
More.
That means my final graph will be
7.08.
Is it clear why I cannot do it by a single formula? Because up to 6.5, I cannot include this as part of my regain buoyancy. Above that, I can include this portion as part of my regain buoyancy. Clear? Okay, is it running?
Recording.
Okay. Let us say that same sum, remember I told you initially 8 meters. You didn't calculate the initial sinkage and got 7.2. If you had worked it out this way, how? If you had imagined that the ship is going to sink up to 8 meters and then you calculate how much is the volume regained because of sinking up to 8 meters.
You will get negative.
How much is this?
2 meters.
2 meters.
2 meters. 2 meters. Now calculate and tell me.
9000.
The value will become 9000. Sorry.
9000.
Can you regain more than what you have lost?
Yes.
No.
No?
No.
So will I really sink up to 8?
No.
I need to regain how much?
5000.
But by sinking up to 8 meters, I am gaining 9000.
Yes.
That means effectively what you are going to calculate, how you are going to calculate. Think that this watertight flat is not there only.
Not there. Not considered.
Think of it as a compartment without any watertight flat. Is it not? Is that watertight flat going to have any effect here? Which is at 8 meters? It doesn't come into the picture. So when you find that your regained volume is more than what is your lost, think of it like a compartment without any watertight flat.
Then you now go for normal method.
Normal method. If you calculate sinkage up to the watertight flat of 8 meters, sinkage is 2 meters. But when you calculate regain buoyancy because of that, it's coming 9000. How much you lost? Is it possible to regain 9000 when you have lost only 5400? You will only regain what is lost. That means your ship is not going to sink by 2 meters. That means the watertight flat, which is at 8 meters, will not come into the picture at all. You have to calculate as if there is no watertight flat. So remember initially how you did without any watertight flat building? This is serves two purposes. If this coming is coming less, it is part of your answer.
Answer.
If it is coming more than loss buoyancy, it is like a check
calculation. Check calculation.
Sir, but this loss buoyancy we are calculating for the 6 meters of water draft, whatever draft is there. But because of the sinkage, the water will still rise to 6.5 meters, sir.
Remember, whatever it is, loss buoyancy is only 6, no?
Buoyancy is
we are not looking at...
No, sir, that 6.5 which you have marked, that portion is also lost, right?
When we took 0.5 minus 0.5, did you subtract that? I have not taken it as part of my regained buoyancy. So there we are allowed for it.
Sir, okay. Sir.
But when I talk about lost buoyancy, it is only up to this initial draft of 6 meters. This I am excluding as part of my regained buoyancy. I am not taking
the center point when it was intact and the draft was 6 meters, that was part of my buoyancy.
Correct.
Now I have lost that amount of space from my buoyancy.
Exactly. So I have subtracted that.
Okay.
So lost buoyancy should be equal to regained buoyancy.
Correct.
That's the concept.
Correct.
So in that formula, regained buoyancy, if we take the increase in draft as x and equate it to 5400, we should get that answer.
But will you subtract or no?
Yeah, the full formula equated to 5400.
If you sink above 5400,
we subtract this as x, sir, instead of putting s, assuming s as 0.5,
180 to 13
okay, x,
if we just assume it as x, just take it as x,
x,
and equate this formula, this equation of 5400.
But will you subtract this? Will this portion be there? Will you take it as x?
It will be there.
It will be there, no? Okay. Now calculate and tell me. Take x common.
4500x.
No, this value is equal to 5400.
1.2.
What you've got?
Oh,
as if there is no watertight flat. Are you clear now? You will get that 1.2 value. Why? I have taken it as x. I am removing up to x.
Yes, sir.
That means it is not considering this watertight plan. Are you clear why it cannot be worked out that way? Correct. That's the reason why we can't directly equate. For the simple reason, I need to subtract this volume only up to watertight flat. After that, this is all part of my negative. That's why I had no choice but to do it in two steps.